Hi, my name is Korey Pereira, and I'm a sound designer and mixer, and today I'm doing some ambisonic recording with the Sennheiser AMBEO VR. An ambisonic microphone is a special type of microphone that actually has four capsules inside of it that allows you to capture the sound of a space, like this car, in three dimensions. By recording this with the AMBEO VR, it not only gives me a super immersive track when I mix and surround, but it also allows you to change the orientation to match the perspective of the scene. So when you're recording audio for VR 360, what you can do is place your AMBEO VR directly under the 360 camera, and then in post, when you add that ambisonic recording and you use a VR headset like the Oculus, it'll allow you to move around with a VR headset and the audio will track the direction you're looking. So when doing ambisonic recordings, there's a couple of things you want to remember. First of all, you want to keep track of the orientation. In general, I always try to record with the microphone pointed straight up. However, most decoding software will also support either end-fire or upside-down orientation. You want to make sure to note this, because when you're decoding it, if you don't choose the right setting, it's not going to sound right. When choosing a recorder, you want to make sure it has four XLR inputs with phantom power and that you're able to digitally link the inputs so that you can control them all at the same time. This is really important when it comes to decoding, because you want to make sure everything is recorded at the same level in order for the decoding process to work. Also, if you're going to be recording outside, it's always important to have some sort of wind protection. My wind protection of choice for the AMBEO VR is going to be the Ryko Baby Ball Gag and Wind Jammer, because it's a really small profile, which I like a lot. It's also important to remember that we as humans make a lot of noise. For this reason, I've set up a way to wirelessly monitor my recordings. To do this, I use the CL Wi-Fi app with the 788T on my iPad and a Sennheiser IFB receiver so that I can step back from my recording setup but still hear what's going on and start and stop recordings remotely. This is definitely one advantage of using the Zoom F4 or F8, because they have built-in support for the AMBEO VR that allows you to decode the signal to a stereo output. So using the same setup I'm using now, I could actually listen to a stereo decode of the recording in real time. So once you get back into the studio, you can take those ambisonic recordings, and using the free Sennheiser AMBEO A to B converter, you can convert those recordings from ambisonic A format to B format, which is then compatible with plugins like the Soundfield Surround Zone 2 for film, or if you're doing work for 360, you can use the Facebook 360 platform to natively take those B format recordings and integrate them into your 360 videos. If you want more advanced control of this decoding process, you can also use the HarpX X plugin, which gives you a lot more control of how it decodes, as well as supports immersive formats like Dolby Atmos with overhead channels. So I hope this video has been helpful. Please post any comments in the section below.